A very good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your science class. How are you all? I hope you all are well and good. Yes or no? So today we'll have the revision of lesson number 10. What is the name of the lesson? Yes, water. So what are the things we studied in this lesson? Do you remember? Once again, I will re-explain all the subtopics and I'll repeat the exercises as well. Okay? So, first of all, let me tell you the subtopics I will re-explain. What happens to the rainwater? The main reason of flood. Why is sea water salty? Do you know the reason? Yes, you remember. Very good. Water pollution. Water cycle. What are snowflakes? A fact about clean water and rainwater harvesting. So these all are the subtopics. Let's revise. Every year it rains during certain months. In most places in our country, the rainy season begins in the month of May, June or July. So in every year, rainy season is there in our country also, in other countries also. Okay. So in our country, when the rainy season starts, rainy season kab shuru hota hai? May mein, ya to June mein, ya to July mein. And it stays for few months. Ya to August tak, ya to September tak, ye rehta hai. All we know that. Yes or no? So, what happens to the rainwater? Rainwater ka ultimately hota kya hai? Jab itna barish hota hai, rainwater kahan jata hai? Some rainwater soaks into the soil and slowly seeps deep into the ground. The water in wells is actually rainwater that collects under the ground. To kuch jo rainwater hai, wo mitti ke niche chale jate hai. Where? Near the level of groundwater. Groundwater ke level tak wo pahunch jate hai. We get water from wells. Wells matlab kuwa. Kuwa se humko pani milta hai. Yes or no? But actually, that water is rainwater, which is collected under the ground. Jo already mitti ke niche, ground ke niche collected hoke rehta hai. Okay. Some rainwater flows away forming small streams. Streams flow from a higher to a lower place. Streams carry rainwater into ponds, lakes and rivers. And baki jo rainwater rehta hai, wo streams form karke, wo ya to pond tak, ya to river tak, ya to lakes tak pahunch jate hai. And the rainwater collected where? In the lakes or in the ponds, or it flows in the rivers. Most rivers keep flowing till they reach the sea. And jo jyadatar rivers hai, nadi jitne bhi hai, wo kahan tak jate hai flow karke? Samundar mein jaake milte hai. Yes or no? All we know that rivers reach to the sea or the oceans. What is water vapor? Do you know? Water vapor is the gaseous form of water. When water is heated, you can see vapor rising from it. Jab hum pani ko ubalte hain, ek vapor streams jaise upar jate hain. Yes or no? So that is the water vapor. Gaseous state of water. Water ka gaseous form hai. The process that changes water into water vapor by heating is called evaporation. तो evaporation क्या है? जो process से water को हम heat देके water vapor में convert करते हैं. That process is known as evaporation. How can we change water into water vapor? By putting heat. ये सुनो, हम heat देके water को water vapor में चेंज कर सकते हैं. That process is known as evaporation. So let me ask you a question. When water is heated, it changes into? Yes, exactly, water vapor. Correct. It is the gaseous form of water. Did you know, when it rains continuously, the rivers get plenty of water. At such times, rivers may overflow, causing floods. तो यही कारण है बाढ़ आने का. When it rains continuously, जब बारिश continuously होता है, बंद ही नहीं होता है, 10 दिन, 12 दिन तक continuously it's raining. Then the rivers are present in that area. जो rivers उस area में रहते हैं, ये पूरा भर जाते हैं, fulfill हो जाते हैं, and overflows and causing floods. जैसे एक glass में हम पानी डालते रहेंगे. So, one time will come, the glass will overflow. Glass से पानी बाहर आने लगेंगे, अगर पानी हम डालते ही रहे. ये सुनो, the same thing happen with the rivers. Rivers के साथ भी ऐसा ही होता है. Continuously बारिश के कारण, rivers पूरा fulfill हो जाता है, and the rivers overflows, and causing floods. यही main कारण है बाढ़ आने का. And do you know why is sea water salty? समुद्र का पानी salty क्यों होता है? पता है सबको? Okay, if you don't know, I'll tell you. Everywhere the soil has salts in it. तो soil जो है, मिट्टी जो है, उसमें नमक होते हैं. When rain water flows from the land, the salt mix with water. तो rain water जब फ्लो करते हैं, बहके जाते हैं, तो मिट्टी में जो सॉल्ट है वो पानी के साथ मिक्स हो जाते हैं. द स्ट्रीम्स टेक दी सॉल्ट्स टू द रिवर्स, और ये जो सॉल्ट है वो रिवर्स तक पहुंच जाते हैं. एंड एज द रिवर्स फ्लो इनटू द सी, दे कीप एडिंग सॉल्ट्स टू द सी वाटर. सो दिस इज हाउ The sea water is salty. यही कारण है कि समुद्र का पानी जो है नमकीन होता है. Now let us talk about water pollution. Most people around the world have access to clean drinking water. However, some areas of the world face storage of drinking water. Water pollution and low quality water can cause many diseases. Nowadays, the water pollution is a very big problem. Everywhere we see the people are polluting water. हर एक जगह पे हम देखते हैं जो people है वो पानी गंदा कर रहे हैं. They do not understand the importance of water. Yes or no? Water is very precious resource. वाटर जो है बहुत प्रीसियस रिसोर्स है. एंड वी नीड टू सेव वाटर, एंड वी नीड टू स्टॉप पॉल्यूटिंग वाटर. हमको रोक लगाना है जो पानी गंदा करते हैं, उनको भी रोकना है कि पानी गंदा मत करिए. क्यों? बिकॉज वी नीड टू ड्रिंक क्लीन वाटर. एंड इफ वी पॉल्यूट वाटर, सो विल वी गेट द क्लीन वाटर फॉर ड्रिंकिंग? नो. If we do not get clean water for drinking, so we may get many diseases. तो हमको बहुत सारे बीमारी हो सकता है पानी के वजह से. So now also time is there to stop polluting water and help others and tell others to stop polluting water. Let us have some more information about water pollution by an audio-visual presentation.
Water is one of the most valuable resources provided to us by nature. We use water for so many purposes, and while doing so, we also make water very dirty. Making the water dirty by the addition of substances called pollutants is called water pollution. Let us try to learn more about water pollution and how we can reduce it Many human and natural activities result in water pollution. Dumping garbage into water bodies is a common cause. Washing clothes, utensils, and bathing animals add dirt and detergents to the water and cause pollution. Untreated waste from factories and sewage from residential areas add toxic chemicals and waste into the water bodies. Water that is washed off from agricultural fields contains large amounts of pesticides and fertilizers that pollute the water of the nearby water bodies. Accidental spillage of oil from oil mining machines into the sea and oil carrying ships is a growing cause of water pollution in the present times. On January 28, 2017, two cargo ships collided off the coast in Chennai, causing a massive oil spill into the sea. This caused a lot of damage to the aquatic plants and animals. Drinking polluted water can cause diseases like typhoid, cholera, and diarrhea. Metals like lead, mercury, and arsenic present in polluted water enter the bodies of aquatic organisms like fishes. When humans drink this water or eat the organisms living in such polluted waters, there is a high risk of lead and mercury poisoning. Arsenic poisoning causes black patches on the skin, and prolonged exposure can even cause cancer. Addition of waste and toxic chemicals to water also raises the temperature of water by many degrees. Rise in temperature alters the life cycle of many aquatic organisms and can even kill the plants and animals living in water. Water pollution has serious effects on us and our environment. So, what can be done to reduce it? One very easy way is to educate people to stop dumping garbage, washing clothes, and bathing animals in water bodies like lakes and rivers. Waste from industries and residential areas should be treated and made free from harmful substances before being discharged into water bodies. Use of harmful pesticides and insecticides in agricultural fields must be discouraged. We too should do our duty and avoid wastage of clean water.
Water cycle. Heat from the sun changes water into water vapor. Wheat changes water into vapor faster. We already came to know in previous class. Yes, as we give heat to the water, water changes into water vapor. Water vapor kya hai? Yes, gaseous form of water. So water vapor gaseous form hai water ka. So heat from the sun. Sun ke heat ke karan jo water bodies se water vapor ban jate hain. Water bodies kya kya hai? Yes, rivers, oceans, ponds, lakes. Yahan se suraj ke roshni ke karan jo pani hai wo vapor mein badal jate hain. Then what happens? Water from the seas, rivers, lakes and ponds changes into water vapor all the time. And this continuous process is going on all the time. Aur ye jo process hai, ye continue hota hi rehta hai. Har din, regularly, suraj jaise ugte hain, then the water starts evaporating from the water bodies. The water vapor mixes with the air and rises upwards. जैसे ही वो वाटर वेपर बन जाते हैं, मतलब गैस बन जाते हैं, then it mix with the air, okay? फिर एयर के साथ वो मिक्स हो जाते हैं एंड ऊपर जाने लगते हैं, means rises upwards. When water vapor reaches a certain height, it cools and changes into tiny water droplets. These tiny drops of water form clouds. फिर कुछ दूर सर्टेन हाइट तक जाने के बाद वो वाटर वेपर कूल्स डाउन, वो ठंडा हो जाता है. सूरज के रोशनी के कारण वो गर्म हो गया था एंड इट स्टार्टेड एवेपोरेटिंग. एज इट वॉज एवेपोरेटिंग विद द एयर इट रीचेस अप टू अ सर्टेन हाइट. कुछ हाइट तक ये जाने के बाद वो जो वाटर वेपर है वो ठंडा हो जाते हैं. जैसे ही वो ठंडा हो जाते हैं इट बिकम्स स्मॉल और टाइनी वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स, और छोटे छोटे बूंद जैसे वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स फॉर्म होते हैं. ओके, एंड दीज टाइनी ड्रॉप्स ऑफ वाटर फॉर्म क्लाउड्स, और यही जो स्मॉल टाइनी वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स है वही क्लाउड्स को फॉर्म करते हैं. देन व्हाट हैपन व्हेन दीज वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स फ्यूज, दे बिकम लार्ज. लार्ज वाटर ड्रॉप्स आर heavy and fall towards the ground as rain. This is a continuous natural process. It is called the water cycle. तो जैसे ही वो clouds form होने लगते हैं then gradually the clouds becomes large. Cloud जो है बड़ा होने लगते हैं. And when it becomes very heavy, उनका वजन जब बहुत ज्यादा हो जाता है देन इट फॉल्स ऑन द ग्राउंड एज रेन, फिर वो बारिश होके गिर जाते हैं. सो दिस प्रोसेस गोइंग ऑन कंटिन्यूअसली, ये जो प्रोसेस है कंटिन्यूअसली चलता जाता है. सो दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज वाटर साइकिल. ठीक है, वाटर वेपर बन के ऊपर जाते हैं, फिर क्लाउड्स बनते हैं, देन द क्लाउड्स बिकम्स हेवी and falls as rain. This whole process is known as water cycle. Did you understand? Okay, very good. Now let us know what are snowflakes. If the weather is very cold, the drops change into snowflakes. This causes snowfall. When it rains or snows, the wells, ponds, lakes, rivers and sea get a fresh supply of water. Snowflakes kya hai? Yes, jahan par snowfall hote hain to snow ke jo barish jaise hote hain. Okay, so those drops of snow are known as snowflakes. The picture, can you see the snowflakes picture? Yes, the shape of the snowflakes can be different. उनका जो शेप है वो अलग अलग हो सकते हैं. कैन यू सी द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ शेप्स ऑफ स्नोफ्लेक्स? यस. सो वेयर इन व्हिच प्लेसेस द वेदर इज वेरी कोल्ड देयर वी सी स्नोफॉल. एंड व्हेन इट रेन्स और स्नोस द पॉन्ड्स लेक्स वेल्स रिवर्स गेट अ फ्रेश सप्लाई ऑफ वाटर. बारिश के बाद जैसे सारे पॉन्ड्स रिवर्स वापस से भर जाते हैं एंड दे गेट पूरा एकदम फ्रेश वाटर सब में भर जाते हैं. ये सुनो. ओहो, नाउ वी विल हैव एन ऑडियो विजुअल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन वाटर साइकिल टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट द कंसेप्ट.
Come, Bunty. It has started raining. Do not play in the garden.
Oh no, I wanted to play more.
No, Bunty, come inside. You can go to play after the rain stops.
I do not understand who pours so much water on the earth and disrupts my lovely game. Is there a shower in the sky?
No, Bunty. There is no shower in the sky. It happens naturally.
Oh, is that so? Sometimes I wonder how rain happens.
Like Bunty, you also must have wondered that how water comes from the clouds to the earth. let us understand it. We know that due to heat from the sun, the water present in oceans, rivers, lakes and ponds turns to water vapor. This process is called evaporation. The water vapor rises upwards due to flow of air. On reaching a specific height, the water vapor cools and changes into small droplets. These small droplets form clouds. When these water droplets and clouds collect into big and heavy drops, they fall on earth as rain. The rainwater flows into ponds, lakes and rivers and finally reaches the oceans. Again, this water in lakes, rivers and oceans evaporates and water vapor is formed. So in nature, this process continues in cyclic mode. This continuous process of formation of water into water vapor, cooling of water vapor to form clouds, and falling of rain from clouds is called water cycle.
Now, let us know a fact about clean water. What do everyone say? कल्पित कथा क्या है माइथ? क्लियर वाटर इज क्लीन वाटर. जो क्लियर वाटर है वही क्लीन वाटर है. बट इट इज नॉट रियलिटी. डू यू नो, ये रियलिटी नहीं है. क्लियर वाटर क्लीन वाटर नहीं हो सकता है. सो व्हाट इज द फैक्ट? यस, व्हाइल क्लियर वाटर मे अपीयर क्लीन, इट मे हैव invisible impurities, germs and bacteria. So water that is clear may be as harmful to drink as water that looks muddy or unclean. तो जो water clear दिखते हैं ये हो सकता है clear और clean नहीं हो, क्योंकि इसमें हो सकता है कि invisible जो दिखते नहीं है इनविजिबल बैक्टीरिया जर्म्स और इंप्योरिटीज हो सकता है. ये सुन लो, यस हो सकता है. सो इट इज सिमिलर टू दैट वाटर व्हिच इज लाइक मडर और अनक्लीन वाटर. सो क्लियर वाटर इज नॉट क्लीन वाटर. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? डू यू नो वाटर वेपर forms all the time, even when the weather becomes very cold. मतलब winter में weather ठंडा हो जाता है. Then also water vapor forms. Did you understand? Okay. And do you know several places in India face severe water storage during the summer months? Many people collect rainwater in underground tanks and use it. This is called rainwater harvesting. तो rainwater harvesting मैंने बताया था ना शुरू में, क्या है हम जानेंगे? Yes. तो rainwater harvesting क्या है? Many places in India during the months of summer, the people they get problem of water. वो पानी के प्रॉब्लम में पड़ते हैं. ओके, सो व्हाट डू? दे कलेक्ट द रेन वाटर ड्यूरिंग द मॉनसून. तो मॉनसून में जब बारिश होता है तब वो बारिश का जो पानी है उसको कलेक्ट करके अंडरग्राउंड टैंक्स में सेव करके रखते हैं. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. आर यू गेटिंग? यस. रिमेंबर, रेन वाटर इज प्योर वाटर. रेन वाटर जो होता है वो प्योर वाटर होता है. इट कैन बी कलेक्टेड, स्टोर्ड एंड यूज्ड फॉर मेनी हाउसहोल्ड पर्पसेस. तो रेन वाटर को हम सेव करके, होल्ड करके रख के, कहीं स्टोर करके, वी कैन यूज इट फॉर आवर हाउसहोल्ड वर्क्स. हाउसहोल्ड वर्क्स मींस या तो बाइक धोना, कपड़े धोना, देन वॉश यूटेंसिल्स. फॉर दीज ऑल वर्क वी कैन use that water. The answer key of the exercises of lesson 10. Question number 1. Tick the correct options. First, streams formed by rain. flow into ponds, rivers and lakes. Second, rainwater that remains on land seeps into the ground. Third, heat helps water to change into vapor. Exactly. Fourth, if a river overflows, it can cause, yes, floods. And fifth question, water vapor present in the air rises upwards and forms clouds. Very good. Have you matched it out with your answers? Okay. Now let's go to the second question. Write the given words in proper boxes to explain water cycle. So this is the diagram of water cycle. You have to fill the boxes with the help of given words. So jo given words diya hai usko proper boxes mein fill karna hai, and we have to complete the water cycle diagram. Okay, so sun, shuruaat mein sun kya karte hain? Yes, sun ka heat jo hai water bodies matlab ponds, rivers, lakes, oceans uske upar padte hain. Then the water converts into water vapor. ठीक है, then water vapor rises and कुछ दूर जाने के बाद वो ठंडा हो जाते हैं, cools. Then next, जैसे ही वो ठंडा होते हैं, they form the water droplets. ठीक है, water droplets form होते हैं, then उसके बाद water droplets clouds बनते हैं. Okay, then as the clouds droplets become large and heavy, they fall on the ground as rain and flows into the water bodies. So this whole cycle goes on continuously, isn't it? And we know this is called water cycle. Matched it out with your answers. If you had done any wrong answer, please correct it out. Okay, done. Very good. Now we will move for the question answers. Question number 3, answer the following questions in one sentence. First, during which season do ponds and lakes get a fresh supply of water? तो कौन सा season में ponds में lakes में fresh water supply होता है? Yes, the answer is during rainy season. Ponds and lakes get a fresh supply of water. Second question, where does water from most rivers go? तो rivers का water ज्यादातर कहाँ जाता है? Yes, your answer is water from most rivers go to the sea. तो rivers से कहाँ जाता है? समुंदर में. Exactly. Third question, define evaporation. Evaporation क्या है? The answer is the process that changes water into water vapor is called evaporation. तो हम सभी जानते हैं, तो जो process से water water vapor में convert होते हैं, वही process को evaporation बोलते हैं, isn't it? Fourth question, what changes water into vapor? Yes, the answer is sun's heat helps water to change into vapor. सूरज का जो हीट है वो हेल्प करते हैं वाटर को वाटर वेपर में चेंज करने में. Now we will move forward for the long questions. Question number 4, answer the following questions in 2 or 3 sentences. In this slide we will talk question number 1 and 3, and in the next slide we will talk on question number 2. Okay, so first question, what happens to the rainwater? Rainwater ka kya hota hai? The answer is, some rainwater soaks into the soil and slowly seeps deep into the ground and form wells. Some rainwater flows on the surface forming small streams which carry rainwater into ponds, lakes and rivers. तो रेन वाटर का क्या होता है? कुछ रेन वाटर जो है सोक्स इनटू द ग्राउंड एंड रीचेस टू द लेवल ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर एंड forms well, ठीक है, and the remaining that flows on the surface and forming small streams which carry rainwater, जो rainwater को carry करके कहाँ तक ले जाते हैं, yes, ponds, lakes and rivers तक. Third question, how are clouds formed? Clouds कैसे बनते हैं? Answer, heat from the sun and wind helps water turn into water vapor. The water vapor mixes with the air and rises upwards. When water vapor reaches a certain height, it cools and changes into tiny water droplets. These tiny drops of water form clouds. तो सबसे पहले क्या होता है? Yes, heat from the sun, सूरज का जो heat है, and wind helps to change water into water vapor. ठीक है, जैसे ही water vapor में change होता जाता है, क्या होता है? Water vapor mixes with the air and rises upwards. Air के साथ mix होके ये ऊपर जाने लगते हैं. Then, when water vapor reaches a certain height, कुछ देर तक, कुछ ऊंचाई तक जाने के बाद, it cools, वो ठंडा हो जाता है, and convert into tiny water droplets, और छोटा-छोटा water droplets में convert हो जाते हैं. These tiny drops of water, ये छोटा-छोटा जो droplets हैं, they form the clouds. Did you get? Very good. Now, question number second, explain water cycle. यहाँ पर water cycle को पूरा explain करना है. So let's read it first of all, then I'll explain. Heat from the sun and wind helps water turn into water vapor. The water vapor mixes with the air and rises upwards. When water vapor reaches a certain height, it cools and changes into tiny water droplets. These tiny drops of water form clouds. When the clouds become large and heavy, they fall towards the ground as rain. This continuous natural process is called the water cycle. तो पहले ही हमको पता है, in previous question also we came to know about that. Yes or no? The heat from the sun and wind helps water to turn into water vapor. As the water turn into water vapor, it mixes with the air and rises upwards. फिर ऊपर जाने लगते हैं. Then कुछ दूर जाने के बाद, it cools down. Means the water vapor cools down and changes into tiny water droplets. और वो tiny water droplets में change हो जाते हैं. These tiny water droplets form clouds. और यही जो tiny droplets हैं, वही clouds को form करते हैं. Then gradually, slowly, the clouds become large and heavy. धीरे-धीरे clouds बड़े होते हैं. और जब ये बहुत बड़े हो जाते हैं, and उनका वजन जब बहुत ज़्यादा हो जाता है, they fall towards the ground as rain. और वो ground के तरफ rain होके गिर जाते हैं. This continuous natural process is called water cycle. ये जो whole process है, इसको ही हम water cycle बोलते हैं. Did you understand? Very good. Now we will discuss the answer key of the value waste questions. As I'll tell you the answers, please complete your book as well. Okay? Value based question. Draw the emoji of happy if the action saves water and the emoji of unhappy if it wastes water. तो ये जो दो faces दिया हुआ है, पहला face कैसा है? Emoji, yes, happy. And second emoji, it is unhappy. तो जो statements दिया हुआ है 1 to 7 में, statements में अगर तुम्हें लगे कि इसमें water save होगा, तो उसमें happy face बनाना, और अगर water waste होगा, तो उसमें unhappy फेस बनाना है. ओके, सो लेट्स रीड इट. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, आई ब्रश माई टीथ विथ द टैप ओपन. टैप को ओपन रख के आई brush my teeth. Yes, it wastes water. That is why we have to put the emoji of unhappy. Second, I brush my teeth using a mug of water. We should brush our teeth by using a mug of water. Yes, it saves water. That is why we have to put the emoji of happy. Third, I use only a bucket full of water to have a bath. So, nahane ke liye, we should use a bucket of water. Yes, this also saves water. That is why I put the emoji of happy. Fourth, I bath for half an hour under a shower. So, here, yes, it wastes water. That is why I put the emoji of unhappy. Next, fifth question. I turn off the tap while soaping my hands. Yes, this also saves water. So, you have to put, yes, the emoji of happy. Question 6. I wash my bicycle using a pipe. So, pipe ka use karke hum apna cycle dhoenge. Yes, it wastes water. So, we put the emoji of unhappy. And the last one, seventh one, I wash my bicycle using a bucket of water. Yes, it saves water. So, you have to put the emoji of happy. Have you completed, everyone? Very good. Thank you so much, everyone. Take care of yourself and be safe in this pandemic.